Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Microwave Engineering video series. So in the last lab, we have seen how to measure S matrix for a E-plane T, and also we have seen how to verify the expression for a rectangular waveguide, and also we have seen the characteristics of reflex klystron. In this video, we are going to see how to measure the scattering parameters of a directional coupler. The setup which we are going to use for directional coupler measurement is almost same as for measuring E-plane T, H-plane T or circulator. So in case of E-plane T, so we have used these list of equipment. So this equipment can be used with a source of reflex klystron or a gun diode. So in the previous video, so we have used gun diode as a power supply and we have measured the S parameters. So in this video, we are going to use these equipment, that is klystron power supply or gun power supply, and we are going to use isolator, frequency meter, variable attenuator, detector mount, waveguide stands, VSWR meter and other required components. So the bench we are going to use is the same microwave bench which we have seen in the previous videos. So in this bench, the first one is the source, gun diode and pin modulator, isolator. This is the isolator. So we have attenuator, frequency meter, slotted section and detector mount. So, and the equipment we are going to use is, we are going to use gun power supply, DSO and VSWR meter. So today we are going to use this particular microwave component named as directional coupler, which is having total 4 ports, port number 1, port number 2, port number 3 and port number 4. So all are rectangular shape, so it is a rectangular waveguide. So we are going to verify S parameters of this particular microwave component in this particular video. Before switching on this gun power supply, so we have to make sure that everything should be in the minimum. So every probe should be in the minimum condition, and then we have to switch on the power supply. We have to switch on power supply, and the connection from this supply will be connected to this microwave bench, and from the detector mount we are going to connect it to the DSO. So we are going to find out V max and V minima on the DSO. So for that, first we have to change the knob of the mod amplitude. And gun bias voltage we have to slowly increase till we are going to receive the waveform on the DSO. So in most of the cases, it is going to have between 7 to 9 volts. So when we change the voltage, we can observe here on the DSO the square waveform, which is desired one. So from this square waveform, we are going to first measure what is the V max and what is the V min. So for measuring this V max and V min, so we need to change the slotted section positions. Then on the CRO, you are going to observe the variation of the magnitude. So by adjusting the slotted section position, so we can see the voltage values or amplitude values on the DSO, that is 7 millivolts, 7.33 millivolts. So you are going to get two values, maximum value and minimum value. So 6 is the minimum value which we are observing when we are moving the slotted section, and when we move the slotted section further, so we are going to get the V max value 9.7 millivolts. So approximately we are going to have 10 millivolts as a V max, and we are going to have 1 max and V min values are measured, so we need to switch on our VSWR meter like we did in the previous videos. So we have connected our output probe to the VSWR meter, and by using VSWR meter we need to measure the power values, that is the incoming power we need to measure, which we are noted as P1 value. So already this particular knob is at 30, so we need to note down the value on the second scale from the bottom. So that is 8, that is 30 plus 8, 38 dB is the power value which we are receiving at this particular case, that is giving input value of 7.76 volts, and after noting down the Vmax and Vmin, so we are getting this 38 dB power value. And now the next step is, so we need to detach the detector mount and we have to connect our directional coupler microwave component. So since microwave component, that is directional coupler, is having 4 port device and we are going to measure output from only one port, so we need to terminate the other ports by using matched terminators, that we are going to see and we are going to connect now. So we have connected one of the directional coupler port to the main section. And we are connecting detector mount to the other port and match terminal to the remaining port. So we have to tighten all these screws because there is a possibility of leakage of power. So now we are measuring power from the port number 2 of the directional coupler by using the VSWR meter. So now our knob is at 40 dB and the reading on the orange color scale from the second one from bottom, that value is around 0.2. So 40.2 dB is the power value we are getting, that is P2 value. So since this directional coupler is having 4 ports, so we have to repeat this process of measuring the output power across each ports. The remaining 2 ports are P3 and P4. When you are measuring output power across P3, the other 3 ports has to be connected, one to the input main section and other 2 should be connected to the matched sections. That we are going to do it now. So we are removing from previous port, that is port number 2 to port number 3. So now we are going to measure power from this particular port. A detailed theory video has been posted in this particular playlist. So if you are new to this channel, please go to that particular video and look at the derivation part of the directional coupler, E-plane T, H-plane T and magic T. So we have terminated the other ports with matched terminators and we are measuring now power from this particular port. So now we have to measure the power values. So now the knob is at 50 dB and the reading on this particular thing is 0.25 dB. So 50.5 dB is the value we are getting at port number 3. That is, we are writing as P3 value. So after finding this P1, P2, P3 values, so we need to interchange the ports. So after finding these P1, P2, P3, P4 values, so by using these relations between S parameters and the power values, so one has to find out the parameter values S12, S13, S23, S14, S24, S34. Since Directional coupler is having four ports. The matrix size we are going to get is 4 by 4 square matrix. So for finding the each value inside the matrix, so we can use this relation formulas and we can find out the values of these each corresponding S parameter here. So here P1, P2, P3 values. So we have done it in the previous steps. So by using those values, so one can find out the values. So here one more thing. So here writing S12 is equal to S21. Basically this is called as symmetric property of the S parameters, that is Sij is equal to Sji. By using that property, we can equate S12 is equal to S21, S13 is equal to S31, and similarly the for other things. So now we need to measure the power values after interchanging the ports. So now on the VSWR meter, so right now norm is at 15 and the value on this scale, power scale is, dB scale is, we are having 3.1. So 53.1 is the power value we are getting for this particular port. So likewise, we need to find out the power values across each port of the directional coupler, and finally we are going to calculate the final S matrix. So after finding the P1, P2, P3, P4 values of the directional coupler, so we have to switch off all the equipments on the microwave bench, especially for the gun power supply. So we need to keep all the knobs in the minimum mode, minimum condition. Then we have to switch off the power supply of the gun. Similarly for the DSO and similarly for the VSWR meter.